What is up, guys? Welcome back to the Pulse Metrics channel. Today, we are at day three of the Major League Baseball rankings. Today, we are going to be doing center fielders. This is by far one of the hardest decisions I've ever had to face. There's so many good center fielders, position switches, and everything. So let's waste no time. Let's get right into it. Starting off, at number 10, we have Gold Glove winner Kevin Kiermaier. They paid the man, and he deserved it. The Blue Jays are going to have a lot of success with this guy. Like I said, Gold Glove, batting 265, 8 homers, 36 RBI, 741 OPS, 322 on-base percentage, 14 stolen bases, 98 hits, and a 419 slugging percentage. Not the best hitter defensively. He is far, far ahead of his hitting. So we'll have to see what he does in going into 2024. And then coming in at number 9, we have Leody Taveras, World Series champion for the Texas Rangers. This guy, another guy who got paid, and he really deserved it. This guy, when he stays healthy, he's a really great player, batting 266, 14 homers, 67 RBIs, 733 OPS, 312 on-base percentage, 14 stolen bases, 136 hits, and a 421 slugging percentage. This guy has just got to stay healthy, and when he does, he's an absolute monster on the plate, monster in the field, monster everywhere. And then coming in at number 8, we have the young center fielder from the Cincinnati Reds. We have TJ Friedl, by far definitely the best Reds player out in there in Cincinnati, batting 279, 18 homers, 66 RBIs, 819 OPS, 352 on-base percentage, 27 stolen bases, 136 hits, and a 467 slugging percentage. Overall, really great player, really great young player. Can't wait to see what he does in 2024. And yeah, there's nothing else to say to that guy, but he's a beast. And then coming in at number 7, we have a little bit of a drop back from last year. We have Brandon Nimmo from the New York Mets. Defensively, this guy's great. Offensively, he's got to stay healthy. Needs a little bit of improvement. Batting 274, 24 homers, 68 RBIs, 829 OPS, 363 on-base percentage, 3 stolen bases, 162 hits, and a 466 slugging percentage. The Mets have had a lot of success with this guy. Always batting first in the lineup, really deserves it. The Mets are, in my opinion, going to be the most improved team from last year, because last year was a little bit of a rough stretch for them. But can't wait to see how this guy bounce back for next year. And then coming in number 6, we have Michael Harris from the Atlanta Braves. Defensively, this guy is a absolute monster. He's everywhere. I don't think I've ever seen him let a baseball hit the ground. Yeah, for batters, you don't want to hit the ball all the way to center field, because Michael Harris is guaranteed going to catch it. Batting 293, 18 home runs, 57 RBIs, 808 OPS, 331 on-base percentage, 20 stolen bases, 148 hits, and a 477 slugging percentage. Michael Harris is won the Rookie of the Year in his rookie year with the Atlanta Braves, a very strong Atlanta Braves team. My guess is that they're going to win the division again, but we'll have to see how it goes. Michael Harris is a beast. And then coming in at number 5, finally having a great, healthy season, we have Luis Robert, the only hopes for the Chicago White Sox to ever win a title. Not like they're going to, but this guy deserves so much better than the White Sox. Batting 264, 38 homers, 80 RBIs, 857 OPS, 315 on base percentage, 20 stolen bases. Surprising for a guy like that. 144 hits and a 542 slugging percentage. By far the best season of his entire career. Hopefully he can keep it up and keep the Chicago White Sox playoff hopes alive. And then coming in at number 4, we have still on the Chicago Cubs, just got his contract renewed, Cody Bellinger. They paid the man, and he really deserved it. Cody Bellinger has turned into quietly one of the best center fielders in the entire league. Had like a rough 2 years before this since his MVP season in 2019. But overall, Cody Bellinger had a great bounce back season, batting 307, 26 homers, 97 RBIs, 881 OPS, 356 on-base percentage, 20 stolen bases, 153 hits, and a 525 slugging percentage. What he did last year was absolutely incredible. Pretty much shocked the entire league. Because that's how good, how big of a bounce back that this guy has had. Didn't let those rough 2 years keep him down. So, yeah, Chicago got really lucky re-signing this guy. And then coming in at number three, we have Mike Trout. Mike Trout, like, as this guy has gotten older, his body is beginning to fail him more and more. This guy has not played a full season since literally 2019. That's insane. I mean, but when he is healthy, he's a monster. When he's not, he's not a monster. He's a little wimpy thing. I mean, this season was by far going to be his worst season of his career, batting .263, only 18 homers, 44 RBIs, 858 OPS, 367 on-base percentage, 2 stolen bases, 81 hits, and a .490 slugging percentage. That's not going to cut it at all. He was basically the only hopes for the Angels to ever go to the playoffs, but he got injured, and Otani got injured. It's just overall, the Angels cannot seem to get anything going. But, Mike Trout has been on the Angels for a long time. Not once have they gone to the playoffs. That's very disappointing. But hopefully Mike Trout can bounce back and have a fully healthy season next year. And then coming in at number two, we have Julio Rodriguez. Man, this guy is one of my favorite players to watch outside of the Phillies. Like I keep saying, he's the next Ken Griffey. Again, convenient, he plays for the Mariners, and he's a center fielder. But what this guy did last year was absolutely insane. Batting .275, 32 homers, 103 RBIs, 818 OPS, 333 on-base percentage, 37 stolen bases, 180 hits, one of the most in the league, and a .485 slugging percentage. Whew! Did I mention that this guy is insane defensively? This guy is like what the best guy like under 25 years old. Julio Rodriguez, this guy has got a great, great, great future ahead of him, and I cannot wait to see what this guy does going into the 2024 season. There's just one guy that's better than him. And that is Aaron frickin' Judge, a monster. I know this might be a little controversial. Some people might get mad at this in the comments, but I don't care. Aaron Judge is a frickin' beast. I mean, it's gonna take a little while to adapt to that new position that he's playing, moving from right to center. But he didn't play a full season at all. But what he did, he made the most of it. Batting .267, 37 home runs, 75 RBIs, 1.19 OPS, .406 on-base percentage, didn't really steal too many bases with 3, 98 hits, and a .613 slugging percentage. If you can hit 37 home runs in under 120 games or so, then just imagine what he can do in a full 162 days. It's 162 games. I mean, but like, who am I kidding? We already saw, like, he hit 62 home runs. Yeah, this guy, I mean, honestly, best center fielder in the entire league. It's not even close. And by far, one of the best players in the entire league. So, yeah, cannot wait to see how healthy this guy stays in 2024 and what he will do in 2024. My guess, he's going to be the home run champion. Alright guys, that is gonna wrap it up. Please make sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe. Not a lot of you are subscribing. We're on the road to 100, so please make sure to do so. I'll see y'all next time. Peace out.